How you doing? It's Steve with James from New York Martial Arts Academy, and today we're going to go over a really cool setup for your knee, right? Now, this is all contextual. Essentially, I'm fighting a skilled fighter. I notice when I fire my left hand, he's slipping, right? And he's most likely slipping to hit my body or to, you know, counter me off of that cross. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show him the cross and boom, I'm going to put the knee right behind it. That knee is essentially there to stop his counter. So I fire the cross knowing he's going to slip, boom, and I put that knee right into the midsection. Again, we're huge believers here in New York Martial Arts Academy that it's not just how hard you hit or how fast you are, it's your ability to set up your tools. Because you could have a great rear knee. It could be picture perfect on a tie pad, work the whole bit, but if you don't have enough setups for it, you won't be able to score with it live, right? Now, second part of this is being dangerous as you recover, right? So we have two options here. When I fire this cross, let's say I knee, I can just as easily go right back to my stance, but why not add one more strike there? So as I'm going to my stance, I'm going to put that hook over the top and finish my combination. So the mechanics of this are pretty simple after the knee. Here, I fire the knee, boom, and then when I'm coming back to center, I'm turning my hips and trying to put his lights out with that hook. So it looks just like this. Bang, turning. So again, we're here, I drive that knee in and I turn back on that hook. This is, again, really cool if you notice that you're dealing with a skilled fighter. You're slipping your backhand. You're going to put the knee right into his solar plexus midsection and try to put him out with it. Thank you so much. Subscribe to the channel, and I can't wait to see you guys for the next one.